Episode 1046, tomorrow starts today.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive.
Happy, happy day. I hope your week is off to a fabulous start. It is Inspiration and Motivation Day, and tomorrow starts today. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, my voice is still a little bit under the weather, so if I sound a little froggy, I'm so sorry, but know that my love for you is greater than the tweaking and the squeaking of my voice. How many times have you said, I will start tomorrow? Well, tomorrow starts today. It doesn't wait until you're ready. The readiness is in the actions you take today to make way for tomorrow. What did you dream last year at this time? I know that's asking you to go back a really long time ago. And some of us are like, I don't even know what I had yesterday, and you're asking me to go back a year? Yes, I am. How close are you to that dream right now, a year later? For me, I can say that I am closer to my dream. However, there is still much work to be done, mistakes to make, no's to be heard, reasons of why something didn't work forgiven in order to move forward. We think tomorrow will be the blessing in disguise. It will be the answer to everything. But why do you stop living today, always waiting and hoping for tomorrow? The work you do today is what will light your tomorrow. Think of today as the lighthouse, shining a light bright for all to see what is coming to be. Even though the holidays may have hurried and overwhelmed you, trying to get that last toilet bowl cleaned, yeah, I know that's keeping it really real here, but that's what we do here at Create Your Now. I've been scrubbing enough toilets and I'll keep scrubbing them, but I'll also have a smile on my face and joy in my heart because you still have today to make your mark for tomorrow. So what are you putting off for another Monday or a New Year's resolution? Yeah, our Mondays are our excuses. Our New Year's resolutions, it's just around the corner. But if you wait for those to happen, you just keep putting it off and putting it off. You're filling your life with excuses. You're living your life the way everybody else wants you to live. You might as well give them your calendar. You might as well have them raise your children. You might as well have them pay your bills. Okay, good luck for finding that and a good friend in that part of it, because who wants to pay extra bills? But all of our excuses add up to today, because we're putting it off till tomorrow. Think about it. I know this is probably pretty heavy on a Tuesday, a holiday week. I get it. But I also get that I could put this off till tomorrow, but tomorrow may never come. And you're here right now listening. You're captivated by the squeaky froggy voice. And you're going, I don't get why tomorrow starts today. I kind of get what you're saying. It makes sense. But I'll still start tomorrow. Your calendar is only an excuse to hide what you really don't want to do. It's your escape to putting off what must happen today. I've done it. I still probably, yes, I gotta admit, I do it. Somebody may ask me, oh, can you do this for me? And all of a sudden, oh, my day is so full. Instead of just saying, you know what? Today I have given myself white space. This is my still time. My quiet time. This is my building my dream time. This is my I've got to clean the toilet bowl time. Whatever it is, but we come up with all of these excuses. They're not living your life. You're living your life. Instead, though, you slip into the busyness mode and agree to do the bare minimum to get by on how others want you to live. All the yeses to fulfill your people-pleasing madness. Think about it. We're all people-pleasers. We all want people to like us for who we are. We don't want to have to change because that makes us feel uncomfortable. It makes us have to work harder. It makes us have to think more. And we all have cleaning up to do. I do, and it's not just the toilet bowls. I don't know why I'm talking about the toilets today. Maybe there's just something that I need to go clean mine. Maybe I'll do it after this episode. But when we have this people-pleasing madness in our lives, we let our calendar become our excuses. We let tomorrow be our excuse. Oh, I'm just going to put it off. Tomorrow may never come. You got to settle down. You got to stop living that life, that madness, the chaos. You're just adding to it. You're not helping yourself, and you're definitely not helping anyone else within the world that you touch. This is the week of gratitude. It's Thanksgiving. Use your time to extract how you want to live, what you want to do with your waking hours, and the three goals you want to accomplish by the end of the year. Think about those three goals right now. I know you already have them. You already went there when I asked you about your dreams a year ago. What were you thinking about, and where are you now? Our minds can take us quickly to where we want to go if we allow that space, that time. But oh no, the people-pleasing madness, the busyness, the hectic lifestyle, all the yeses, very minimum no's, and the excuse of it'll happen tomorrow keeps us fulfilling and being grateful what we have today. You have blessings right before you today. Yeah, maybe today didn't work out the best. Maybe you woke up late and hit the snooze 3 times and you really only meant to hit it 2 times. And now you're running 15 minutes late and now you've got me in your ear and you're like, oh, I'm so guilty. Don't feel guilty. You're forgiven. Move on. Move forward. The next time you go to hit that snooze button on the 3rd time, say, oh, what happened? Maybe 2 times of snooze is enough. Or just set your alarm back by 7 minutes and get up when it goes off. Strategies and tools you can give yourself to build up instead of tear down. So use your time this week, because we all have a little time. You're going to eat maybe some turkey, especially if you're here in the U.S., and you're going to sit there and go, okay, I'm a little groggy sitting in your recliner. If you're a football fanatic like me, you may have a game on or 2 or 3 on 3 or 4 different TV channels. And you can ask yourself, how do I want to live my life? What do I want to fill up my days? What do I want my waking hours to be? Do I want to live in this chaos? Do I want to have no white space, no room, no flexibility? Do I want to just keep piling on everybody else's stuff, not being able to do what I want to do? You have a lot of time between now and the end of the year, more than 30 days. That's enough to make a major change, a major shift in your life. You see, the best preparation for tomorrow is doing your best today. That's what H. Jackson Brown Jr. says. Tomorrow starts today. What are you waiting for? Look at today as a way to lay the groundwork for what tomorrow will hold. Tomorrow will bless you as you see the blessings in today. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.